Hi, I'm Stephanie from Spark Employment Services, presenting you Back to Business, short videos designed to let you know what changes have been made since reopening and what you should expect before visiting certain businesses and organizations. Today, we are joined by Heather Haynes, Manager of System Performance at Compass. Hi, Heather. How are you doing today?
I'm good today, Stephanie. Thanks. How are you?
I'm great. Thanks. So could you tell me a little bit more about Compass and what you do?
Certainly. Compass provides a variety of services for young people up to the age of 18. These include supervised access and exchange service for parents. We have a youth justice program, and we provide psychology assessment and intervention services for young people who may have a diagnosed or suspected developmental disability. The bulk of our services, though, and our staff work in our mental health services. So we provide individual and family-based counseling as well as group programming. We work with a number of community partners such as school boards, Health Sciences North, and child protection agencies to try to best match the level of services to the level of need that a client or family may have. We have also services and offices in a number of different communities. So we have an office here in Sudbury, but we also have one in Espanola, in Little Current, and in Shaplow.
Wow, great. So can you tell me a little bit about how COVID-19 has affected the way you do things and what new changes and accommodations have been implemented, as well as what the future might look like for your organization?
COVID-19 has had a really significant impact on the way Compass provides services. As you might imagine, most of our services are delivered face-to-face with children and their families. And so we, you know, had to move to a virtual service delivery. So a combination of phone and secure, you know, Zoom or Ontario OTN network as well. And it's been interesting, quite a learning curve for our clients, but also for our staff. And so there was some initial hesitation about receiving services and providing services that way. However, at this point in time, about 50% of our client contacts are delivered through video. And people are really quite happy with it, to the point that some people are asking to continue receiving services that way.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
So what would you like people to keep in mind as organizations such as yours are reopening and ultimately changing everywhere?
Well, I think like a lot of our community partners, you know, we've had to do a lot of work to come up with a plan to support our staff being able to return to the office and to be able to see our clients face to face. And I'm happy to say that as of 2 weeks ago, we started providing services face-to-face, might be 3 weeks ago, it's on June 29th. We started seeing clients face-to-face. And so the biggest changes really have been about how we actually do that. So we normally have a walk-in service called Mindspace, where people can just come in sort of off the street or, you know, after school. And to talk to a counselor. We've had to move all of our services, though, to appointment-based services. And so we still have Mindspace, but people do need to call us to be able to schedule those appointments, but we can do it very quickly. We've implemented lots of, you know, health practices and keeping with public health guidelines like other people in the community are doing as well in terms of hand sanitizing stations. And our staff and clients do need to wear masks when they're here. Those are probably the biggest changes that we have at this point.
Okay. Well, thank you so much for your time today, Heather. It's been a real pleasure talking to you and learning more about your organization. This has been Back to Business with Compass. Thank you so much for joining us.
Okay. Thanks, Stephanie.